Hey everyone, this is Kristin Sherry. Thanks for joining me again for another episode of Maximize 365, a year of actionable tips to transform your life. So if you've been working through the self-discovery playlist or the videos in that playlist, you will know that now we're on the fourth pillar of career fit. And if you're brand new to this, don't worry. You can still do today's episode and then go back and do the other ones. They don't have to be done in the right order of strengths, values, preferred skills, and interests. You can start with this one. So today we're going to talk about discovering your career interests. And so your career interests really influence your preferences and to some extent your motivations. So you might be really good at something and have the natural talent, or really good at a skill but just feel like meh about the whole thing. Like, I'm not really, this doesn't light my fire. Your passion usually comes from your values and or your interests. So the quote today comes from Anne Bogle and says, "My personality traits don't determine my destiny, they inform it." So this is just one of the four pillars. So your personality informs your career choice, but it's not a direct one-to-one. And so many times you'll hear career practitioners saying, well, I use Myers-Briggs or this or that to help people with their career, but that's really a one-legged stool you're sitting on when you look at just your personality. You also need to know your talent, what's important to you, and the skills that burn you out or energize you. So, do you know how personality influences your career interests? So there are six personality types that shape your interests at work. And the way you can remember it is RIASEC, R-I-A-S-E-C. So it stands for realistic, investigative, artistic, social, enterprising, and conventional. And I'll explain that. So the realistic one, the first one, are also known as the doers. So when you have people who are doers, they like practical, hands-on work that is really contributing to solving practical problems. And people with a realistic primary type don't tend to enjoy desk jobs because they like that tangible hands-on. So they might become veterinarians or even an ambulance driver or something where they are out moving around, not chained behind a desk. So when you have a student with a realistic primary, you can bet they're not going to enjoy a traditional corporate or office job. So the next one is called investigative. Those are the thinkers. And thinkers are intellectual, curious, and reserved. They like to solve problems and engage in challenges in their work. So they don't want to check their brain at the door. If there's not some sort of intellectual rigor, like research or mental problem solving, strategy, they're not really going to be very interested. They'll sort of check out at work. The third one is called artistic. This is called the creator. Artistic doesn't mean art, that, you know, painting and drawing. Artistic is my primary, followed by investigative, the thinker. So I like to create using my brain, which is why I write books. Creators, it's really about, do you like to create things? So they're imaginative, they're creative, they're original, they're independent. They really like to work independently. That doesn't mean that they don't like to always work alone per se, but they like that autonomy, if you will. And they're expressive and they avoid highly structured and routine work activities. It's like the death of a person who's an artistic or a creative to have those really structured, rigid deadlines, for example. The next one is social. Those are called the helpers. And social doesn't mean extroverted, or that they're social butterflies. It means that they're interested in serving society. So think of social as society. So they want to make a difference. And so you generally won't find social people when social is their primary in corporate America. They tend to gravitate towards education, healthcare, nonprofit, even social work, things like that. So if you have a social primary, or if you have a student with a social primary, you're going to know right away that they're going to probably gravitate towards those helping professions. So they like to help people and their work is centered around helping people. The fifth one is enterprising. These are called the persuaders. So persuaders often deal in leadership, so they could become chief executives or directors, C-suite, but they also could be entrepreneurs, or they could go into politics because politicians have to persuade and influence. So these professions tend to involve decision making, making or selling products, and starting up things like a startup. And then the last one is called conventional. This is also known as the organizers. So when you think of any type of an organization, they need the first person that a coach or consultant tends to hire when they can afford to hire someone is a virtual assistant or an admin or even an accountant or a bookkeeper. But it's somebody that's creating process and structure for that coach or consultant. So they provide the order that businesses need to run well. And when you pick your top two, one more than one is going to sound like you. It gives you a lot of insight into how you want to show up at work. So your preference would be to think and create if you were wired like me. If you were conventional and social, you would help people by creating structure and order. If you were realistic and social, the helper and the doer, you would help people by practical hands-on help. So a paramedic, for example, would be a realistic social. Let's see, let's do another combination. So if you were enterprising and investigative, persuasive and thinking, you might be a strategist. And so you might be more targeted towards an executive position in a company, for example. I'll do one more to give you the idea of this. I think you probably get the idea, but if you were artistic and conventional, you would be interested in creating things that had order to them. So think about maybe people who like to do cross stitch or very detailed type artistic endeavors, or even someone who likes to make clothing with making their own patterns, that there's a structure and order to it, not a free flow painting type of thing. So for your idea for action, I would like you to take your career interest test, and you can go to bit.ly/careerinteresttest, and it's free and each word is capitalized. I'll put the link in the description for you, but the career is capitalized, interest is capitalized, and so is test. bit.ly/careerinteresttest. So it doesn't take long at all to do this. It's very quick. And I'm curious to know, what are your top two? And anytime you're thinking about taking a new role or getting involved in something, you can ask yourself, will I blank and blank? Will I think and create? Will I help and organize? Will I do and create? Whatever your two combinations are. If the answer is no, it's probably not going to go with your preferred work style. It's going to go against the grain of how you really prefer to show up at work. So I hope this is helpful. I'd love to hear what your top two types are and how well does it fit what you're doing right now? And what might you do to tailor your day, if you can, if you have any influence on that, so that you're able to use your top two preferences a little more. And if you're trying to change careers, start thinking about that as you're looking at job descriptions. Will I blank and blank your top two career types? So I hope this was helpful, and let me know your two types in the comments. Take care.